Hi guys, I'm Neria from Falcon Safaris and I bring you Africa safari and travel information tips right at your fingertips. Now we all know that Africa is a prime destination for safari, and with the number of countries to choose from, you can actually get stuck trying to decide where to go on your safari and when to go on your safari. And that's where I come in to help you make your decision a lot easier. I will be explaining to you one of those options that you can choose from when you decide to go on your next safari, and that is the Chobe National Park in Botswana. So stay tuned. The Chobe National Park was established in 1960 as the Chobe Game Reserve. It was actually established with the motive of protecting the wildlife within the area, as well as boosting tourism in the area. Just 7 years later, it was then converted to the Chobe National Park, and it became the first national park in Botswana. The Chobe National Park was named after the Chobe River, which is actually the main source of life for animals and people within and around the area of the Chobe. It is also called the Land of the Giants. This is because it is home to the largest elephant population in Africa. Within the Chobe National Park itself, you can actually find up to 120,000 elephants living in the park. And also, secondly, Chobe National Park is home to the largest lion population in Africa. You will also find a lot of zebra due to the zebra migration, and you'll also find large herds of buffalo within the area. For tours and safaris, you can actually have a lot of game viewing, and there are a lot of different options that you can choose to view your game. You can choose to view game in a game drive, or you can actually choose to go on a boat cruise, or you can actually choose to go fishing. There are so many different ways that you can actually experience the wildlife within the area. And the tours can also be combined with day trips to either Victoria Falls from the Zambian side or from the Zimbabwean side. This is because the Chobe National Park is located on the northwestern corner of Botswana and is strategically positioned very close to the Zimbabwean, Zambian, and the Namibian border. So tours can actually include going into and out of Botswana to visit the nearby areas and the nearby countries. The best time to visit Chobe National Park is during the dry months from August to October. This is because in the drier months, there are clear skies, the vegetation is less dense, and this allows you to spot animals easily, even those that are actually at quite a distance. The drier months as well allow you to travel swiftly and nicely through the park, as opposed to the wet months where the ground would be muddy, making it difficult to be traveling in and around the park. And not to say that the wet months are bad for game viewing, they are okay, for especially for those that love bird life, because this is around the time where migratory birds move into the area. So for those that love bird watching, the wet months are actually a very good season for you. And for those that are opposed, and to those that really don't like the scorching heat of the dry months, then the wet months are also for you. What to experience in Chobe National Park? In Chobe National Park, you will experience a safari of a lifetime, as there is the river and also the park that is the most biologically diverse. Chobe National Park is actually considered the most biologically diverse national park in Botswana due to its different landscapes and terrains, as well as the different species and varieties of wildlife that you find within the park. So you will actually experience a very unique safari. Now, as you know, Botswana is half a desert, half of the Kalahari Basin. So the Chobe National Park, right in the northwestern part of Botswana, is actually full of vegetation, lush vegetation. So if you have been to the central parts of Botswana that are mostly desert, you will actually appreciate Chobe National Park and in all its fullness and with all its vegetation and all its wildlife. Some of the most frequently asked questions about Chobe National Park is, how do I get to Chobe National Park? As I had mentioned before, that Chobe National Park is strategically located close to the borders of Zimbabwe, Zambia and Namibia. So for you to get to Chobe National Park, you can actually fly into Botswana through the Kasane International Airport, and you can drive to the entrance of the park. You can also fly into Zimbabwe, Victoria Falls National Park, and drive about 2 hours into Botswana, that then drive to the national park. You can also then choose to arrive in Livingstone and then also take a drive to Botswana. For accommodation, there are lots of places that you can choose to stay. Some people actually prefer to go on houseboat safaris and stay in a houseboat for 3 to 5 days on the Chobe River. There are also lodges and camps within the area. We have the Chobe Safari Lodge, Camp Okavango, and Delta Camp. So those are some of the places that you can stay when you visit Chobe National Park. For more information, please do contact us. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this video with your friend. Thank you.